Yeah, cup plunger. What do you need?
I told you to wait because I was yawning, Gabe.
Hey, I can put a shovel of gravel in your mouth. Hey, you were
start to feel
yawning so much. Hey. So this is it, Captain Blush.
I'm actually very tired. I was just cutting firewood, and I was cutting it directly when I came home from work. So
well, it still looks winter where you stand, eh? It does look cold, Captain Blush. Hey,
these spruces are all in snow, eh?
Oh, Captain Blush, eh? But hey, all for a sexy widow.
Yes. And what? I thought you had disturbed me. Welcome to our channel, where we don't edit nothing because we don't know how, and this is just what we do.
No, because we don't want to edit.
No, because this we is want the to channel. Show you the truth and nothing but the truth. So help me God, eh?
Yeah, from amateur point of view, and that's it, Captain Blush. Good enough because we have said that we will film shorter videos, eh?
Yes, and this will not be
because nobody is watching 30 minutes videos because this is nonsense,
and
eh?
Because this. And this will also not be a long video because yeah. There's actually not a lot to do here.
Because you have such a special plane that in fact it doesn't need much of assembly, and that is why we have decided that in fact we will assemble it on the video. And what it is, Captain Blush, tell us, dear Captain Blush.
It is a DRACO Wilga from E-flite. Look at this. I didn't show you yesterday, but actually there is an instrumental panel.
Yeah, inside. Instrumental panel is working inside.
We will show you when we will
because,
cut the battery.
Yeah, we have said that you have 17 lights all around the plane, but if you count them here, where the hell are they? But in fact,
one, two.
Yeah, but hey, Captain Blush, stop counting because I will tell you right now that you have a few in the instrumental panel inside. Eh?
Yeah.
The beautiful, sexy, iconic DRACO Wilga and Captain Blush will assemble it for us today.
We will not postpone nothing. We will just start.
Well, yeah. Now, of course, all you need a plane.
Yes.
We have the wings here.
Robert has already pre-glued on the stabilizers.
Yes, the slots, because this you have to glue on the plane. And because we didn't want to wait here on the camera, I have glued them this morning. So you must be still careful, Captain Blush. For that, you will need a glue.
Glue and
this pins.
These pins.
Pins to hold them. I will show you like this. This is how I have secured them a little.
These are needles or pins, eh?
Yeah, pins,
isn't
yeah.
Isn't there a song? Needles and pins?
Yeah, of course, eh, Captain Blush. Now,
yeah.
You have
what
a few
else?
Parts.
Ordinary pliers, crooked needle nose pliers, Phillips screw, smaller, bigger one. What's this?
Yeah, some kind of hex.
Socket. 5.5 millimeter and
5
millimeter, and we will be using Slovenian tool Junior.
Yes, of course, the famous Slovenian tool. And of course, when Captain Blush will assemble this plane, then he will put inside the smart battery, because this plane does come with smart technology. And I will try to bind this plane today on the video. Let's hope it will work on the brand new NX6
where
radio.
Where will start with,
Yeah, start somewhere. Turn the plane around and start with the landing gear, the main landing gear.
So I will turn it on its back?
Yes, like this.
Like this. You have to be careful not to... You have to have enough height on the stand so we don't mess with this.
Yeah, so you don't make some holes in the plane.
Yes.
But the point is that, in fact, you must have the stand. It's so much easier to assemble the plane. You can get them cheap on the internet or on some modeler stores.
And when we start this, well, I have to...
Yeah, follow the instruction manual and that's
it,
Captain Blush.
I have to make a point here, right? Because actually, if you follow the instruction manual, it says 3 times 10 millimeters.
And that
well,
is...
that actually...
Well, today, Captain Blush, it would be good if you have the micrometer, eh?
Because...
But we have discovered earlier that in fact...
It is not true, eh?
Yeah, it's not true because...
There are no bolts that size, but there are bolts 3 times 20 millimeters.
Yeah, because in fact, you already have the nut inside of the plane.
Yes.
The fret in the plane.
We were checking where does these bolts go, but actually... These are the bolts for the landing gear.
Yeah, because they are 4, so it's logical that
These
are correct. Look at this, the bigger.
These, the smaller ones are actually just
to one size to other size. There is no
four. Yeah, the small ones you have two sizes, and that is Captain Blush for the steps and for the counterweight for the flaps.
Ah, yes.
Yes, and these four are for the landing gear.
Now we will start with this, and then later we will screw on the tires. But look, wait, I just cannot look at this enough. Look at this.
I mean, this is perfection. You have seen viewers on the unboxing that this is really, really quality, good, done plane. Now check the sides, Captain Blush, good. So everything will fit perfect, eh?
Yes. This is my first test fit. Is it okay?
Yeah, like this. Oh, like this. Wait. And now you have the perfect fit.
Yeah.
On this side, it is perfect. Look at this.
And here also, like this, yes.
And when it will be tightened, the gap will disappear.
No, I mean,
they have
this.
Even put it here, my friends, the plastic edge here, so it goes with the landing gear. I mean, this is unbelievable.
Yes.
Is it?
Yes, these are the correct screws.
Are the correct? Yes. 10 millimeters.
But I will tighten them
diagonally. Diagonally, Captain
yes,
Blush.
But first, I will tighten them
just a little. Don't be too strong, but yet these again. Don't be too weak.
Where's another one?
Yeah, you have them there. One is on the instruction manual, Captain Blush.
One is here, and the other ones were there.
Yeah, and the other one is there. But it looks already so sexy, huh?
This?
Look at this.
These are four screws, as we say. This one not.
This is such a sexy assembly. Not much, but just enough to get familiar and to get in love in the plane.
Yes. Now I have this. Crooked finger here, like this.
Is it fitting? Okay.
Sometimes I wish I would had.
Is it good?
Electric tool. Yeah, it is. But I just have to check once more. Like this. Now you tighten them in.
Oh, tighten them good. Diagonally, Captain Blush, because later, when you will. Tighten them good. You will cover them with this foam. I will give it to Captain Blush.
Wait.
Because it does have the tape on.
Like this.
This one.
Like this.
Is it good?
Oh. Hey.
It looks so sexy already.
They are holding the landing gear.
But right now, that is so different. The plane looks so much different right now with DSA.
But does this go where? On the ESC?
Not on the ESC. You must cover these bolts. But what's with you, Captain Blush? Like this. Do you see this?
The bolts are outside.
Yeah, the
bolts. Oh, so you can retighten them, eh?
Yeah, because later, you must still get some access to take the landing gear down. I mean, here you can see that
you can take the landing gear down even if you put this on.
Yeah, but it's easier to put them inside now.
I have taken off the labels.
The tape.
The tape.
And do it sexy. And look how much sexier does this look right now, but you still have the access to the bolts.
And you still have cooling for the AC, which is very important.
A salute. E-flite for this, because
now we will use 5.5 millimeter socket.
Yes, because Captain Blush will take off
the wheels. Now I will put on the wheels.
You will take off the nut here.
What are you doing?
I'm showing this side.
Yeah, the nuts.
And then you must put the washer on each side of the wheel.
Yeah, one washer goes here.
One must stay on.
I'm talking now. One washer is here, one goes on the tire, and another one goes onto the bolt. There are three washers. Now, landing gear, it doesn't matter which side. One.
Like this.
You can come here, eh? Now you put one washer which goes onto the axle. Then you put a smaller washer. It goes here. There is for the nut, like this.
Just be careful, don't drop your nuts, eh? Because
you have to,
it's hard to find them here, eh?
Yeah, you have to be careful about the nuts because it's very cold. So they can.
We have the winter here, so hey.
The shrinkage can occur, so.
Just tighten just enough, Captain Blush. Check.
Do you know what's good about this? You can do it like this, and then later, when you need leverage, you
if
just.
If you
do
need
it
the power, when you need the power, Captain Blush, eh? Try. Like how does it roll?
And these are protective nuts, which has plastic inside, so they don't unscrew.
Is it okay? I don't want the wobbly wheels, but just enough.
Yeah.
Are they wobbling?
They're wobbling, but not the axle. Look at the axle.
Yeah, but you can tighten a little more.
No, that's it.
A little more.
No, there's a shaft. The screw is just...
You can't tighten the more. Yeah, but tell me that,
if
Captain.
If you will tighten more, you will screw the screw.
I don't like the wobbly wheels, say.
Yeah. Well, this time you will have to be.
You can turn to yourself. You will do it like this.
Well, I have big arms, so.
Yeah. Okay.
Unscrew this now. Look what I was talking about.
Mm-hmm.
There is just so much thread here. So, where can you thread some more, eh?
Why it is zooming on you all the time, eh? Not on here.
Because I'm so big, like this.
Now we can see. It's so interesting, eh? When you put the hand in the back, it starts to zoom.
There is so much thread and that's it, eh? It can go much further inside, you see? Look.
Yeah, but that is... I can see now.
The washer goes here.
This is so good because they have done it in a way that you don't have to think nothing, eh?
Yes.
Just tighten the nut and you're good to go.
Like this. Another one like this. Now, you tighten it like this, and when it comes
when it stops
to the end,
a little more,
and that's it.
Hey. Pretty sexy.
It rolls so good, just like it would have ball bearing inside. Look at this. Now, this is done. The landing gear is done. Now, what?
Yeah, so leave it like this.
Yeah.
No,
I have to
turn. No, leave it like this.
It's not, I'm not lefty, eh?
And of course now you will also put
the back wheel
in, and then you can put the plane on the wheels.
On the wheels. Like this. Now you will use this back, and I was just thinking of something.
Now this back in fact is packed in a way that all that you need for the back is in this bag.
Yes. The screws already on, you just take them off, and for this one we will use 5mm socket, like this.
And the screwdriver.
Yeah, we can use the big one, because the big, like this. Now,
should I grab it for you?
No. Well, what if I would be alone here, like this, just unscrew.
Yes, because first you must attach the wheel inside.
For springs. First we will attach the springs.
The main wheel.
What?
No, first the wheel. This one that you had taken out.
Didn't you say that we have to put the springs first?
Yeah, but you have to put the springs in.
Yeah, but I have to take this
but
off.
Not that spring. These springs. This.
Yes, but I have to disassemble it first. How will I disassemble
it
later?
Yeah, but that one goes here, Captain Blush, on this one.
Yeah, but I have to take the bolt out. How will I do it when everything will be on?
It will dangle down.
Yeah, dangle down. Why should it dangle if I can do it like this? This, you thought these ones, huh?
Yeah.
No, you have.
Yeah, check the manual, Captain Blush.
You have disrupted me so now that I don't know what I'm doing, eh?
It's okay, you will figure it out, it's not hard.
Like this? Like this?
Yeah, but first you must put the springs in.
What am I doing right now?
Yeah, put them in.
Yeah,
and then you will put the bolt through here. You can do it later, of course. If you will put the wheels inside, later you will have to take down this, the servo arm, to do this.
Yes, because...
Yeah, you can see what kind of position of the wheels you need if you want to put this together. And now this is it, Captain Blush.
Now you put in the bolt.
And now put the bolt through.
Uh-huh. The bigger one goes here.
Even if you don't do this, my friend, say you can later, like I have said, you can take the servo arm off and put the springs in.
Yes, like this. Now, I will It's a good thing that I don't have crooked fingers on my right hand. Like this. Now you don't. But
if you can't turn, usually, if you can't turn the nut, then you just hold the nut and you can turn the screwdriver to get started.
But in this case.
Is it okay?
Look at this.
Just enough.
Look at this, huh?
Hey.
Perfect.
Yeah, but now, of course, now.
The spring.
Yeah, and this is what makes the difference on this plane, because in fact you have the, but this is the spring, the oil spring, or how do you call it?
Yeah,
this?
But I was just looking at this. I think they took this from some Baja planes, you know, cars.
The cars, yeah.
Yeah, those ones that goes from the deserts, they have such big suspension. Because I was reading on the springs, it says off-road racing shocks.
Yeah, of course, eh? Uh-huh. Yeah, but these are the wheels, eh? It still are the wheels like the wheels on the cars.
Yes. Like this.
And they have thought so good through this plane, huh, Captain Blasche?
Of course they did. Like this. And we check it.
It works perfect.
So that's it.
I mean, this is amazing, Kate.
So, the back landing
gear is done. Now all gear, that yes. You have to do is put the cover on.
The cover is here.
Yeah, yeah, the cover.
Here's the cover, and you get the screws inside the cover, inside the back. I'll just put this here, and I will take a look.
Just, Captain Blush, be careful, because here we have four more screws for later, uh-huh, to put them on the wings.
Now, I think this goes like this. First, I will do your side. You cannot go wrong. Look at this. It fits.
They have thought of everything. I mean, look how much cooler the plane will look with this, because it will be closed, so you don't see. This is unbelievable. Huh, Captain Blush?
Yes. Even for me, when I don't like foam planes so much, it's so easy
to... Yeah,
but
assemble. Captain Blush have said that that lately, even he becomes fond of the foam planes and electro.
I just wish they would be on some...
Yeah, you just wish that they would be made from wood and with the glow engines. Captain Blush, eh?
Because if you assemble this, you can assemble this on camera. If you see it for the first time for 20 minutes, when you assemble the balls of plane, yeah, you must take what? 15 hours, say.
Yeah, even in the ARF version, if you have the balls of plane.
Yeah.
But if you have the kit version, then that means a few months.
You know what? I will leave the plane like this, eh?
Yeah, you can put inside.
Now is the turn for the horizontal stabilizer. Now you just put these supports
away like
on
they
the
are.
Outer size they are. Now you just take a look. Here is the slot inside.
Because it's amazing,
this
my
slot
friends.
This goes into this.
That you can even disassemble the elevator. You can even disassemble.
Now listen to this. Yeah.
And that's it, eh? I mean, this is unbelievable.
That's it.
Then if you want to unattach this, you must just push here again on this.
You can do
and
it.
Look at this. And you have perfect, sexy, slim plane
wait,
to put in the car.
Come closer. Are you zooming?
Yeah.
That's it. Now, we will attach first the... Is this... Oh, yeah, like this.
Yeah, you can do it like this.
I will do it like this.
He will detach... attach... needle nose pliers.
No, don't need them.
You're the man, look at this, eh?
Yes, like this, and then...
And you also have the ball linkages for supports for this.
Yes.
It should go.
Like this.
The snap, could you hear that?
Yes.
The click sound.
Like this. And the other one. Like this.
This is unbelievable. This is the solution. I mean, this is the solution that you don't see
I
every day.
I will not force nothing, eh?
Don't force it, eh?
We will do it when we will plug in the receiver.
Aha, you can open the back. I think that you have here the access to the servo. But this is it. Salute me. Salute me.
And because they are,
friends,
and
you
because
have the access here.
Yes, and because they are metal gear, you will not screw them.
Yeah,
so fast,
you won't. If you have the plastic gear servos, don't do that by hand, eh?
No, we will just
Well, they have thought of everything.
Look, and now you can see how good these small, sexy ideas come to hand. I mean, this is unbelievable. For once, you have the plane that you don't need the tool to disassemble the back of the plane. No, this is unbelievable.
This will be the first time that the plane will be on its own wheels. Look at this.
Yeah, I'll show the suspension, eh?
Yeah, no, okay. That was my fault. I didn't look where I was pushing. Yeah, you will glue this on.
Oh, I will glue it back, show the suspension.
Well, feel me. I was reaching from this side and I didn't look. This is
we have shown you what not to do, eh?
Well, this is my fault, so.
Captain Blush, eh?
Excuse me, Horizon Hobby.
Yeah.
My mistake, eh? No, this is suspension.
I mean, this will work on our runway, eh?
Yes. For the back one.
Yeah, but that's it, eh? Ooh, the back, look at this, eh? Look how the back is absorbing.
Yes.
Now, of course,
What?
Put the stand back, Captain Blush, because you can put, do you know what?
What?
Put the stand back, the steps to go inside. You must still screw them on, eh? And the plane must be tilted around.
Steps?
Yeah. Wait, I will help you. Like this. Put it back. And you will see here, do you see? Here inside, look. And you have here, here you have the holes, because the big screws, these two, and these two steps will go there. While we still have the plane,
take this out,
turned around.
Well, there are a few more things that we will do after the filming, not on the camera. You just, these are for the wings.
These you just put in, so if you touch the wing down, you don't, these are the steps. And these are the counterweights for the flaps.
So. How do we put this?
And these are, in fact, the steel. Huh?
Like this?
Turn them to you. Like this. Yeah.
Oh.
And then put screw. Yeah, check if this is okay. I don't think that this is okay. Is it?
Maybe the left and right? Of course they are.
Check. Because I think that they must.
No, I had the right one.
Is it?
Yeah, the correct one. Like this?
Now it is. And just put the screw in. Because you can see.
Are you sure that the big one is here?
Yeah, I don't know. Huh? Is it?
Yeah.
Well, I think it is because you have the bigger hole than here. If you check this, you do have here the small slot on this.
Yeah,
one.
This is. No, the bigger ones go here.
But in fact, hey, I didn't know that in fact this is.
What's the real weight or what?
Wait. This is made from aluminum or what?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, it's aluminum.
Brass.
Only this is plastic here at the end.
It really is the counterweight for the flaps.
Yes.
Uh-huh. We can show it once.
Is it okay? Do you see the hole?
Like this, I can see the hole now. This is unbelievable. I turn it to you.
No.
So okay. It will be easier.
Huh. It's okay. You can show the viewers, say.
Like this.
Okay, that's it from this side.
Yeah, now you have you tightened it good?
Uh-huh, you can put later on the
The down antenna.
You glue it in, but we will not do it now.
Yeah, this one, my friends, I will glue on the plane because this one will not bother me. But the ones on the top of the plane and on the wing, I don't think I will make something from magnets or something so I can remove them because in fact, later, if you want to store the wings, that antenna popping out will not be
we
so
need
good.
This again? No, no, no.
Huh?
This?
No, you don't need that one. And now we have the steps on the plane.
Well, this again, is, I'm sorry about this.
This is
okay.
But I will do that. Who cares?
I wasn't looking, okay, but now I'm just.
Who cares?
Distracted. Now.
I have enough glue, eh? So, and now we show the viewers, take one wing, that in fact.
Where are you holding the camera? What?
Uh-huh. Yeah, I'm watching here. That in fact, I have used. Don't throw away this foam that was inside in the plane, because if you stick the carbon bar through, you have here the place to store it between the wings later if you put this on the shelf or if you make yourself a bag. And even this I won't throw away because this was for the transport of the wings in the box, but I will put them in here Later on the runway, yes, when we will disassemble the plane, so if accidentally the wing falls down, it won't fall down on these
connectors,
and you won't ruin them. So don't throw this away. We will use this on the runway later, eh? Because I will make the bags for the wings.
And now, will I leave this inside for later?
Just be careful.
I will leave this inside for now.
Yeah, leave it, because it must dry through the night. Now you must put the carbon bar through.
Yes.
But we can show the viewers, and we have shown yesterday here, the way it say, that in fact this one is pretty thick.
Yes.
Usually it's not such a thick wool on the carbon bars. I mean, this is amazing. Okay. Really, really big one. But it should be, because it doesn't have the support for the wings.
No, where should I start? On your side?
Yeah, take out the bolts, yeah, whatever you want, who cares, eh? Yeah, you can take that one that you have at your... Who cares?
And this?
Just take the bolts out first.
Yes, I will take these bolts out. And I will use... I will put it like here, like this, yes. Mm-hmm. I will use the pliers.
Because you can do this by your hand.
Very gently.
But it's easier with the pliers, and I will make some attachments here. I will put something so it will be easier to pull them out.
Yeah, when you will pull them out a few times, I think that it will get easier, right?
Yeah, but it shouldn't.
Yeah.
It must be a snuggly fit, Captain Blanche.
Now, the marriage, as we say.
Now stuck it in,
The wings get married to the plane, eh? Like this.
Oh, it went
look
in.
Look at this, eh?
That's it.
Hey, this is unbelievable,
now,
huh?
Now I will disappear for a second, eh?
But it's so sexy because I will tell you...
Now it's just a matter of putting them in and rotate them, eh?
Yeah, but the point is that first time that I see the plane, that if you put the half of the wings on, the plane still stands like it should be. It doesn't tilt on the side of the wing, but...
Hey, this is so easy, eh?
Is it?
I have done it with just one finger. I mean,
now, of course, I will show the viewers, you still have a little hole here, do you see this, eh?
Yeah.
We have a little hole here, and in this hole goes this little thing that I will glue this one, I will glue inside this.
What's this?
This is something, I don't know, it's even on the real plane, this, but I will put this on later, I will glue this, because this is not important now for the assembly. These are just small things that really makes the difference on this plane.
Are you melting down again or what?
Yes, Captain Blasche. I still have my winter pants, because in the morning it was pretty cold.
This fresh glue, you have to be careful, like this. Now,
I mean, this is unbelievable.
Second,
this is unbelievable. Eh?
This, I'll take a bit closer. Now, look at this. Yeah, that's it. That's it.
Hey, this is unbelievable. And later, Captain Blush, you will grab it in your hand and we will see how big, in fact, this plane is. I mean, hey. And now, because the camera doesn't do the justice to the plane, it really doesn't. The plane never looks so big on the camera as it is in real. But Captain Blush, hold it in your hands now, eh?
What?
Yeah, the plane. Just plane. A little. Yeah. Just so we will see the size of this, eh?
Well, I'm a big man, so...
Yeah, you're a big man, but look at the size of the wings. I mean, look at this, my friend. Say, look, wait.
I'm a little big.
Look.
Hey, I'm big, but the plane is bigger than me.
But look at this, eh? I mean, look at the size of this, eh, my friend. Put it a little lower, Captain Blush. Like this. And now you can see, look. Now you can see the size of this plane. Huh? Yeah, it looks so sexy, eh? And this is unbelievable, eh? Huh?
So... I think the power is cool. The battery.
Yeah, put the battery inside for me.
No, we will put the propeller on after the filming.
Yeah, not now.
After the filming, and we will show you how the propeller works on the runway. Because we don't want to love our fingers. Sir.
Hey, we still love our fingers, but we will hear if the reverse is working, because I did set the reverse in the radio.
As I said, this
this
things
yeah,
goes
this underneath here.
I will call this ski, say sled skis.
This goes inside here. So if you touch the ground, you don't touch the wing on the ground. This is the protection.
You can
and
put
this in fact is the stuff that saved Mike Patty from many injuries, I think. Eh?
Yes.
When he crashed this plane.
Now I will put the battery inside. You will just put this Velcro aside.
But hey, the assembly was so sexy. I mean, this is unbelievable. Look at this. Look at the size of this.
Like this? No.
You must see this in real to believe.
How can I put this?
Yeah.
Like this?
Yeah, whatever you want, Captain Blush, because it doesn't matter, because this is not...
The CG. I'm not sure if it is from this or from the wings. I think it's from the leading edge of the wings.
Yeah.
100 millimeters to the back.
To the back,
but we will check this in the manual.
Check in the manual. They even say that if you have the 4-cell batteries, you must put all the way forward on the battery tray. If you have the 6-cell 5000 battery, you should put the battery in the middle of the tray. And if you have 6-cell 7000 battery, you should put it all the way back on the battery tray.
I'll just, because I'm very interested, I'm very...
Yeah, I don't think that they measure from the slots, Captain Blush.
Well, I will
you check the CG from the tip of the wing. From here.
From the leading edge.
From here, my friends.
Sled.
Don't... What?
It says from leading edge of wing sled. So we must measure it from here. From all the way, from here.
No, I don't think
this
so.
This may be 100 millimeters, huh? This dot here. Look, it says it in the manual.
Aha, uh-huh, from the slots.
Yeah.
This is interesting because usually you don't measure this from the slots.
Well, we will check this
from the sled slots or what? Aha, uh-huh, sorry, check the manual. It does say from here 100 millimeters, but hey, I will check that later because this is not important right now. Yeah, of course, Captain Blush, you will grab the camera.
Like this.
Oh,
the camera has 50 degrees Fahrenheit.
Yeah.
Not 50, 100. What this, eh?
Oh, this is unbelievable. Viewers, salute, eh? Of course.
Yes.
I will go behind. Thanks, Captain Blush, for assembling the plane for us.
Yes.
And of course, like we said now, the time is to plug this baby on the radio. Now this does have the smart, Captain Blush, I will do this later, eh? We have forgotten to put, I mean, we still have a few things to put on, eh? We didn't put on the counterweights.
Yeah, where did they go?
Yeah, underneath the wings. I will do this later. It goes underneath.
Yeah.
And you put this on the tips of the wings, like we have said, you put the antennas underneath, one here, do you see this?
Yes.
And one here.
Yes.
Now this one I will put in with the glue, but this one not. Because if this antenna will stick out like this, how can you put this now in the back?
You will put some magnets on, eh?
But these are the real, steel. Don't put poke your eye on this. And of course, just these two things that goes in front of the wings, like I have said, and then it is all that should be assembled on this plane. Now, of course, like Captain Blush, I have said, I have already set the radio for this. I was following the instruction manual.
Yeah.
Exactly. And what I have discovered, in fact, if you have the 6-channel radio, even if you have the NX6 radio, you can't put here the safe select.
Uh-huh.
Because all the channels are taken, even that 7th channel, phony baloney channel, is here for the reverse thrust. And you can't, I was thinking maybe not to put, I don't know what, the lights maybe, or the reverse thrust. I would risk something of that. To be able to set the safe select on this plane, but in fact you can't, because it is already set, if you have the bind and plug version, it is already set in the plane that it must be like this.
Uh-huh.
So if you want to have also the safe select on this plane, you need the 7-channel radio.
Yes.
Did I say it good, eh?
Yes, you did.
I will put it like this. So I will come to the front of the plane, like this. and we will see what will happen. Like I have said, every time you set the plane for the first time, never ever have the prop on the plane. That is one thing that you must remember forever and ever.
Yes.
Because you just have one fingers, and that's...
No, you have 10 fingers, but everyone counts, eh?
Yeah, every finger counts, my friend, say. So this is it, Captain Lush.
Yes.
I will just turn the radio on. Like this. And now I will show you here what do you have. You can check here in the monitor. I have the flaps here.
Take off flaps. Flaps up.
It will take one channel. I have the rates. I have the mix here. Do you see this for the throttle,
yeah,
for the reverse?
Brakes on.
And you have this one, the gear channel for the lights.
Uh-huh.
I was using the gear channel for the lights because, in fact, for the lights, they do have around 7 different modes of working.
Oh.
And if you put them on the slider, on the roll button, then you can use all the 7 pre-installed
pre-programmed
linking and I don't know what. But if you don't have that channel, you will use one channel for the lights, and at least that you can do, I think that we will have the 3 options for the lights, eh?
Yes.
Good enough, Captain Blush. Mm-hmm. And of course, today it would be useless to bind this plane in the safe select. Now that means if you want to bind the plane to safe select, turn the radio on, prepare it to the bind position, then put in the bind plug, plug the battery. Once you hear the one beep, take out the bind plug and then bind the plane, and you will have the option to safe select. And since we can't have the safe select on this radio, I will just put the bind plug in and just leave it to the end of the binding game.
Yes.
Good enough?
Yes, good enough.
And that is why we have here this beautiful access. You can see here, I will take out the back wing like this. I will open this. I mean, this is unbelievable. And for this, I can salute Horizon Hobby. Such a great idea to come to the point of the plane, to the veins, the I don't know how to call this, eh?
The arteries.
The arteries, the veins and something, because the heart of the plane is the motor. And I will do this, and that's it. I will leave it here, and we will bind this in the totally normal way. I will go out here.
Yeah.
I will go in the system.
Well, this winter ski may come in handy on this plane, eh?
Sexy, huh?
Huh?
And I will go here to the bind, and I will plug it in, and what the hell, eh? Now I don't have the full battery because it has put it itself to the storage mode, but it will be good enough to bind this, eh? Like this. We go here.
Ah, the battery is showing you it's not full, huh?
And that's it! Uh-huh, look at this! This is when the smart technology comes handy, because it's showing me that, in fact, if I don't have the checker, I already know that the battery is not full to be on the runway. So I will unplug it right now. I will shut this up like this.
Just press the X.
Wait, Captain Blush, don't do it with one hand. I will take this bind plug out, like this. Put the cables back inside. Cover it.
Uh-huh. This is perfect, eh?
Cover it. I mean, this is unbelievable.
As I said, this is the
look
most...
Look at this. I mean, this
the
is
most sophisticated plane yet, eh?
And this looks so sexy, eh? And we will see. I just wonder what kind of lighting we will have here. Now, I have set this for the first time to 5 minutes. Of course,
no, plug it back in.
Uh-huh. I have seen the guys flying this plane for almost 12 minutes. But for the first time for the runway, I think that they do recommend it in the manual. We will put it to 5 minutes and that's it, and measure it after that. So this is it.
Yes.
Now let's try it for the first time.
Uh-huh. Oh, look how bright is this, eh?
And this is it, my friends.
At the motor, it's not...
Yeah! You have also lights here underneath.
Yeah.
Do you see? You have the lights there.
Uh-huh.
You have the blinking lights on the tips of the planes.
Yeah.
You have also the lights here.
These are the landing lights.
Yeah, I don't know. You can see where the wheels go in the dusk. You have the light also here in the front.
Ah, this is for the other settings, huh?
Yeah, and that is then you have the different settings. We will see quickly. Show now. This one is light on. The back one.
And of course, the cockpit, eh?
Do you see inside? Wait. Don't grab it like that, Captain Blush.
What will it be? Oh, look, the red. Where can I show this, eh?
Which one?
Like this.
Do you see inside?
Two green and one red. Display.
Do you see it inside?
Yes.
And we now have only one light on the back. Do you see? We don't have the top light on the top of the plane.
Yes.
But wait, now I will try to. Now, first I will try if everything is working. Arrows. Ah. Hey,
the mix.
Do you see this?
The mix with the aileron.
But I didn't do the mixing.
Rudder.
Yeah, but have you seen, my friends, when I have plugged in the plane, the surfaces moved only once. Now that means that the plane was bind in just AS3X select. Now that means that we will have just a little assist if we have some windy days for the smoother flight. We don't have the safe on, but it's interesting that it already has the mixing. Look at this, I mean, this is unbelievable. So this is already mixed inside in the program of the plane, in the receiver. Do you see this?
Yes. Do the elevator.
Support.
Do the elevator.
This, the elevator.
Uh-huh. Right. Flaps.
The flaps. Flaps. Now the flaps are directly according on the book. Don't set them on yourself.
Uh-huh.
They are preset. No, they're not preset.
No?
I have set them.
Uh-huh.
But you must set in the type of the plane you do. You make one aileron and one flap, and then you go in the flap system like it says in the manual, and there I have set this, because even with the flaps, look at this, not just the flaps are in the correct position and slow down. Check when I push the flaps, I already have the mix to the elevator.
Uh-huh.
Check this. Do you see?
Yes, two positions.
Because of the ballooning, you already have the mix. I mean, this is unbelievable. And look, I was just wondering, do you know what I have wondering?
What?
I have wondering one thing, that in fact, if maybe I will need to set something manually, the ailerons, do you know, sometimes when you plug and bind the plane, maybe they are not good done.
Uh-huh.
And since we have the Y cable, if I will need to do something manually here on the plane, but in fact, look at this, they are perfect already,
Yes.
This is not just some phony baloney plane. Even when you bind it, everything is, surfaces are like they should be. I mean, this is amazing.
Throttle.
Now, let's just check if the motor is working. Now we can see that it's working here in my side, correct?
Yeah.
And now I will try to do the reverse. This is unbelievable. Uh-huh. Yeah, but come here. Do you see this?
This is turning to me now.
To you, and if I put the brake off.
Yes.
I mean, this is unbelievable. Now, of course, to use this feature, this is something. I mean, this is not easy. Don't be fooled and don't be screwed, and be very careful so you don't do this in the middle of the air in the flight.
Oh.
Be careful, because you will lose the plane. This is something that you train after you land, and that is why I put this on this side of here.
Yes.
Because you will have to, when you will land, you will have to take down the throttle, take it down, because it does have the brake on. Take down the throttle and then quickly switch and
the nut is spinning.
Yeah, and then you will brake the plane on the landings. But this is something that you must train. Don't think that you will just do this like Mike, eh? This is not easy, eh? I don't think that I will do this much on the runway. I will use this not for the landings, because with the landing flaps, I think that this plane will be so slow that it will land anywhere, eh? But I will use this. That to be sexy, to be
I don't know, to be the macho man, because if I will come from the runway to the cockpit, to the pits, I will come in the reverse side.
Yes. Now try the lights.
Aha! And now we will check if this is working something. Now we have seen the ailerons are working, the elevator, the rudder, the motor, the reverse of the motor. Let's just check now if we do have at least three options for the landing, for the lights, say. And I have them on this switch here, which in fact you will use the gear for that. And that is why I thought that maybe I will be able to use the safe select, but you can't because you are using the gear for the lights here.
Yes.
This is it. Let's try.
Uh-huh.
Do you see this, eh?
Yeah, but only the back one started to work.
Ah, yeah, but something else.
No, only the back one.
Uh-huh, now I have the back.
And the red here, I think.
Ah, and the red and the green.
Uh-huh.
Check, wait, I will put it first one.
Yeah.
Now, what do we have here? Aha, uh-huh, we don't have the tip,
yeah.
the strobing lights on the tip of the plane, and we don't have the strobing light on the top. So if I put the second position,
yes.
What do we have now here? We have the strobing light here, the backlight, the lights here. We
the green, the red. Lights,
except
for the front.
These lights underneath and these lights.
Not
the
try
front.
This third position.
So we try the third position.
Yeah, hey, do it.
Pray to God that this one will light up on the third position. It doesn't take.
Turn off the lights.
Oh, the third position is so we don't have nothing there. So this is it.
Maybe you change the parameters inside, eh?
Yeah, I will check.
But not now.
No, of course, I will not check. No, I just wonder, the parameters.
Yeah, the percentage of the throws. It will just like if you were turning the knob.
Okay. If you will set it like this, now, of course, if I had the 7-channel radio, because the 7-channel or 8-channel radio, they already have the turning knob, the knob here, and then you will be able to use what?
50 minutes.
50?
Yeah.
It can't be, Cap. You said that it will be short, eh?
Yeah.
Of course, what I was trying to say, yeah, but that's just a fact of life. If you will have the NX6 radio by now, I mean, I will check this, if maybe I can make some more light settings. So this means that I can save the juice on the plane, on the battery. If I put it all the way down on the third position, I don't have no lights. If I have put it on the second position, I have a beautiful sexy strobing lights, which I love the most. Now this one does look sexy, huh?
Yes.
This is the perfection, eh? Because if I put it in the first one, this is not good, eh? I only have the lights here, but maybe sometimes you just want to have the tips of the lights, because this plane has so many lights that in fact, you can fly this almost in the dark, eh? In the dusk, I mean, the plane is so sexy that this hurts, eh? I will just go to the second one, and of course, I will close the video. So this is it.
Yes.
What to tell at the end, viewers? Like I have said, the Horizon Hobby has done really good job, eh? The plane looks really sexy, the plane is big. You must see it to believe it, how the big plane is. Everywhere you look, it is perfection, but still you must be careful, like you have seen. You can pop
well,
something.
That was my fault,
yes. You can
yes.
pop something out, I will glue this back, this is not so hard to do. And like I have said, antenna, I don't know, you can put them or not, who cares, that is up to you, eh? And like I have said, you have seen here, what you will be able to do if you have the 6-channel radio.
Yes.
You will be able to control the whole plane, but you will not have the safe select and you will not have the four options for the lights. You just have three. In fact, you have two options and one off, and that's it, eh? Good enough?
Good enough, yes.
But I'm really thinking maybe Captain Blush today. Maybe I will fly. And of course, I have set myself the rates on this plane. I have the mid rates, the low rates, and the high rates, of course. Eh? But
yes.
It's interesting, and this is unbelievable. Eh? I must try something. Oh!
What?
And what this, eh?
What? It's the same as it was.
Yeah, but that... Oh, yeah. Hey, I'm crazy! I'm getting
well,
here Fata Morgana.
Yeah.
I thought... because you know what I'm trying to do? I'm trying to see why does it have all the time the mix with the rudder. If maybe I can turn that mix with the rudder off, eh? Maybe this one. It's interesting, why is it working all the time? I mean, it seems like...
It doesn't matter.
It seems like, yeah, but it does matter. Do you know when it does matter? It does matter when you do the roll with the plane. Because when you do just the roll with the plane, it's not good to have also the rudder with that one. But in the turns, the plane will turn much more beautiful and sexy if you will have the rudder also working. But that you must do with the hand. But this one was already set. It looks like it's already set.
So that's it, eh? Because
50 minutes, my friend say. I mean, this is unbelievable.
No, it's almost 60 now.
We have set what?
Yeah, it's going towards the 60 now, eh?
This is it, Captain. Pilot Robert and Captain Blas signing off for Slovenia with beautiful and sexy DRACO Wilga. We have set it to NX6 radio, and now all that it have to do is to go to the runway and test the beautiful, sexy pen. And that's it. Good enough.
Yes.
But Captain, salute. And thanks for all support, and Captain Blaska, quick, because what?
Nothing.
Nothing, I don't know what. I will sit here and think that maybe I will also set my 9-channel radio, the DX9, to this plane. Like I set it just like this, and all that I have to do is just rebind it again, and just for me, just for my pleasure, maybe I will have a different light, say. So this is it.
Yes.
Captain Blaska. Viewers, thanks again and just expect more. I really hope that next time we will do the shorter video. I mean, it's so interesting that the more simpler the planes we have, the longer the assembly
videos. Yes, that's because you just can't stop talking.
Yeah, but can you imagine if we have the almost ready to fly version, if we have the balls of plane, I mean, friends, that would be a year of filming, eh? Non-stop filming for a year, eh? Yeah, Captain Blush, you all know that I will talk as long as I see the
red
light.
I will cut it off because this is getting crazy.
Red light, Captain Blush, I will talk. Cut the red light.